What is Dream Adventures? What do? This is our mission statement. We help extraordinary teams build extraordinary companies. How do we do this? This is our method. We de-risk startups. So whether it's legal, customer acquisition, app development, hiring, a little bit of firing sometimes, our goal is to get those early stage hurdles out of the way as much as possible. Don't get me wrong. These companies are going to have hurdles in the future. But this is a sweet spot. This is where we operate in, this early stage 90-day cycle where we can get as many of those hurdles out of the way quickly. We have been doing this since 2008. To date, we have launched 167 companies. We can definitely clap about that. There are some alums in the audience as well. We started right here in Philadelphia in 2008. Since then, we've added New York City, Tel Aviv, Austin, and Baltimore. After today, we're going to have 179 companies. Okay, so what does DreamIt bring to the table? Well, first off, and it may seem a little counterintuitive, we do bring some capital to the table. We give these companies 25K, but to be honest, that's not really important. All right? If you ask these companies, that's basically beer money, ramen money, rent money. But it is a stamp of approval from DreamIt that we are investing in these companies. Hopefully, we're going to invest in the future. But that's the first thing we offer them. Second, we bring them here to the Science Center, 3401 Market Street. We have a great partnership with the Science Center. Beautiful brand new space we just moved into. Anything an early stage entrepreneur could want. So we got ping pong, Legos, Xbox, you name it. We moved in. This is what it looked like. Nice and beautiful, nice and pretty. Day 90, a little less so. So we work hard, and apparently we sleep hard. That is me. Sleeping under the hustle sign, not ironically, but that it turns out that is the most comfortable place in the office to sleep. So not only do we give them office space and 25K, we pair them up with technology resources. So if we're talking about de-risking, we offer them HR, accounting, cloud services, printing, all these types of little things in the beginning at a deeply discounted rate or sometimes free, and these companies are a part of that. We also pair them up with the best law firms in the city of Philadelphia. So I am a former lawyer myself. I know how these early stage legal issues can be very, very critical. And these law firms offer up their services pro bono for a 3-month period for these companies. So I want to take a moment to both thank the law firms and the technology and accounting and HR resources that have come for this cycle. Thank you. Another unique aspect of DreamIt is we pair each company up with a mentor. We had 12 companies this cycle. And we had 18 mentors. So sometimes one, sometimes two, sometimes three, sometimes four per company. It really depends on what the needs of the company are. And whether it's strategy sessions, whether it's many introductions to potential investors or potential clients, over the past 90 days, these mentors have put in over 500 hours of their time dedicated to these companies. So I want to say thank you to the mentors as well. And as we've seen in the past, these mentors will likely stay involved with these companies, whether joining them full-time, sometimes as employees, sometimes as board members, and sometimes as investors. So not only do they have great mentors, they have a great program manager. So Melissa here in the middle wearing the appropriate DreamIt gear. Thank you, Melissa. Everything from immigration issues to quizzo nights, Rosh Hashanah dinners at her house, weekend dance parties, Melissa handled it all. So for those of you in the room who have built a company, you know how heavily you rely on interns, sometimes a little bit too much. We rely heavily on our interns, as do our companies, and I want to take a minute to thank the interns. Thank you, guys. So what is DreamIt like day to day? Well, first off, it's a lot of fun. All right. If it wasn't fun, we wouldn't be doing this. So we certainly work hard, but we do have a lot of fun. So we have poker nights, had a Halloween party, we had our first ever baby shower. More on that later. On a slightly more serious note, we have board meetings each week. And this one just happened to be during Halloween. But these board meetings are a crucial part of DreamIt. These are as real world as possible so that when these companies come out of DreamIt and they have future shareholders and they have future board meetings, they know what it's like to have their feet held to the fire. They know what it's like to have that pressure cooker on a weekly basis. So we have the board meetings where they learn from us, but they also get to learn from each other. And this is what's called a fishbowl. And in a fishbowl, each company each week comes up and talks about a broad-based issue that they are working on, that they are focused on, and they get to work with each other to figure those out. I think they're very lucky because these are insanely smart people from top universities, top industries, helping each other out on a daily basis. And we had a very particularly collaborative group this year. So not only do we have fish bowls, but we actually had guppy bowls. And the guppy bowls are kind of weekly flash meetings. Somebody's coming up and saying, I want to change my logo today. Can I get your feedback? I'm about to head into an investor meeting. Can I get your feedback? So really, really quick iterative process as much as possible. So not only do the companies hopefully learn from myself and the Dreamit partners, they also learn from each other. To some degree, we learn from them as well. Let that settle in for a second. For the happily... So for the happily married folks in the room, my wife's sitting right here, apparently Tinder is a dating site. Who knew? All right, so where do these companies come from? They come from all over the world. This year we had 400 applications. We found entrepreneurs in India, Thailand, China, Canada, Chicago, Atlanta, and right here in our backyard. We had our most diverse group to date, and in large part that is due to Comcast's support of our Access program, which focuses on minority-led entrepreneurs. I want to take a minute to thank Comcast for that. Thank you. Next year, we have another program in a similar vein called Dreamit Athena, and that is in partnership with the Pennsylvania Department of Community and Economic Development, where we will focus on female-led entrepreneurs. To that end, our next cycle starts January 30th. Applications close in 5 days. All right, there are some of you in this room who've always wanted to be an entrepreneur, who have great ideas. Today is the day to apply. If you know somebody who's an entrepreneur or wants to be an entrepreneur, has a great idea, tell them, let us know. We want to see as many of those applications as possible. So enough about the past, all about the future. These are the 12 companies that we are going to unleash today on the world. And I mentioned a little bit about collaboration and how collaborative this group was. And I was looking for a leadoff hitter, and I thought, who would be the best suited for this? And whether it was arranging guest speakers or weekends, was it salsa dancing? Salsa dancing or late night basketball, Nikhil led the charge. Full of energy. He's super excited to tell you all about InfoShare.